Learning different things and knowing stuff helped me prevail to be where I am today. And it helped guide some of my artwork. If I didn't have all these experiences, a lot of this work probably wouldn't exist that I've created. Yeah, so I was born in Durham, North Carolina. I was able to get out for grad school and end up coming back to teach at Duke. I grew up seeing a lot of stuff, you know, and experiencing a lot of things. One parent household, my mom, I was able to, you know, I grew up seeing her struggle, you know, to put me through private school.
Being a single parent was hard. I worked lots of jobs. I worked three jobs, full-time job.
But she also seen that I was good at working with my hands. In that second grade, she got me a real workbench with real tools. So, you know, I've been making for a long time with tools. You know, my mom was that person that was like behind me full force, like, yeah, if you want to do it, you can do it. You know, as I got older, I thanked her and I was happy, you know, for everything that she sacrificed to get me where I am. I had an older brother, 15 years older than me, born on the same day. So he was like a dad to me too, you know. It helped show me around. You know, when people see me around, be like, hey, how your daddy? And they mean my brother. How you feel like my brother? Yeah. I broke a toy when I was a kid. It was a little remote control car. And my brother took it apart and it had like this motor inside of it. The same little RC motors that they have in all the cars. He took that motor and he connected it to a 9-volt battery and that motor ran. And I was like, oh my gosh, as a kid, like, yo, I can break all these toys and make stuff. You know, I was already that kid that would like pick up sticks and rocks and collect them and make stuff with them. But then knowing that I could break these toys and make new toys out of them, that's when I started like really breaking stuff and making stuff out of it and seeing how things work. And then when I got that workbench in second grade from my mom for Christmas, it was like, yo, I really can start like finding things and breaking things out of them. So I jump in dumpsters to this day. Like, hey, yo, like I wanna see what's in there, what somebody's thrown away, and see if I can make some kind of treasure out of it. You know, that saying, one man's trash is another man's treasure.
My best friend told me, she says she was very proud of Stephen. And she says back in the days, she would see him around the house just tinkling with something, bothering something, and she says, that boy got a problem. But she didn't know that he was he was making things. And now she's looking, she and her mom, they're just really proud of Stephen. But she says, I thought that boy was crazy.
I guess, you know, when you're in college, you know, it's just you. You know, you don't have your parents riding you and stuff. I took advantage of the studios. I stayed in there throwing pots, doing ceramics work to a point where they were like, hey, if you want to stay after hours, you can stay after hours and you can work. So I stayed after hours and I worked in there and I made as much as I possibly could. One of the professors saying that I was good at what I was doing, came to the house, took photos of all my ceramic work, built me a portfolio. Before I left Central, my aunt was like, hey, why don't you apply to SCAD? You good at art? I know I didn't have the money to do it, and they gave me a little scholarship, not much at all. My best friend's parents, they came to the house and they seen some of the artwork that I was making, and they bought some of the work, and then they also gave me another little loan to help me for my first semester. It was hard all the way through grad school because I didn't know much about the art world as far as artists and art history and stuff. That wasn't like my thing because I was more about the physical making of things and being able to capture my audience attention with the artwork, and also not wanting to be put in a box where it's just like, oh, you just make stuff about black people or black art. And at a certain point, it felt like they was telling me that I wasn't an artist, or at least one of the professors. I always called my mom probably every week. It was like, hey, they say I'm not an artist. I don't want to be here. The same for me, you know. And she kept saying like, yo, just stick through it. You got it. You can do this. But when I was in grad school, I told the teacher, I was like, hey, I just want to wow my audience. I want to do something that's, you know, that's going to stop them in their tracks. And one of the professors was like, all right, we'll do it then. And I was like, well, bet. Let's do it. And ended up making a work that's still touring. It's been touring since 2010.
But when I seen Cash Crops, I'm like, my gosh, my child did this.
It's all about adapting. You know, even with my artwork, I'm adapting to different materials and different tools or mediums.
So I'm very proud of Stephen and what all of his accomplishments. It's really beautiful. Good son. He's a good uncle. He's just a good young man, and I'm proud of him. That is what I have to say about Stephen. You know, I love you, Stephen.
Love you, Mom.